Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Today we'll discuss about some question of second chapter. So the first question is, name the parts of an angiosperm flower in which development of a male and female gametophyte take place. Which means female gametophyte and male gametophyte were happened. The male gametophyte or the pollen grains develop inside the pollen chamber of the anther, whereas the female gametophytes, also known as the inverser, develops inside the nucellus of the ovule from the functional megaspore. That means male gametophyte developed inside the pollen chamber and the female gametophyte, which is known as embryo, develops inside the nucellus and it is from the functional megaspore. The second question is, with a neat labeled diagram, describe the parts of a typical angiosperm ovule. An ovule is a female megasporangium where the formation of megaspore takes place. That means inside the ovule, megaspore develops. Here this is a structure of mature ovule. This part is pinnicle. This portion is micropyle. This portion is hilum. This is micropylar pole. And this is outer integument, and this portion is inner integument, and here it is nucellus, and this is embryo sac, and this end is known as chalazal end. Yeah? So the various parts of an ovule are filmical. It is a stalk-like structure which represents the point of attachment of the ovule to the placenta of the ovary. That means through the filmical, ovule attached with the placenta, and filmical is the stalk-like structure. And what is hilum? It is the point where the body of the ovules is attached to the pinnicles. That means here the body hilum body is attached to the pinnicles is known as hilum. And what is integument? There are the outer layers surrounding the ovule that provide protection to the developing embryo. That means outer membrane of a ovule that protects the embryo is known as integuments. Integuments is two types, that is outer integuments and inner integuments. The outer layer is known as outer integuments and the inner layer is known as inner integuments. Now what is micropyle? It is a narrow pore formed by the projections of integuments. It marks the point where the pollen tube enters the ovule at the time of fertilization. That means through the micropyle, the pollen tube enters into the ovule due to the time of fertilization. This nucellus, it is a mesh of the parenchyma's tissue surrounded by the integuments from the outside. That means nucellus is covered with integuments. The nucellus provides nutrition to the developing embryo. The embryo sac is located inside the nucellus. That means in nucellus ke under embryo sac located and nucellus developing embryo ko nutrition provide karte hai. What is chalazal port? It is based saline part of the nucellus from where the integuments originate. That means from the chalazal port integuments are originated. What is triple fusion? Where and how does it take place? And name the nuclei involved in triple fusion. What is triple fusion? Triple fusion is the fusion of male gamete with two polar nuclei inside the embryo sac of an angiosperm. That means when one male gamete fuses two polar nuclei is known as triple fusion. So due to triple fusion, endosperm is produced. This process of fusion takes place inside the embryo sac. So where triple fusion occurs, this process of fusion takes place inside the embryo sac. And how does it take place? When a pollen grains fall on the stigma, they are germinate and give rise to the pollen tube that passes through the style and enters into the ovule. After these pollen tubes enters on the synapses and releases to male gametes here. That means when pollen grains fall on the stigma, through the pollen tube it releases two male gametes. Out of two male gametes, one gamete fuses with the nucleus of the egg cell and forms zygote, and the other male gamete fuses with two polar nuclei present in the central cell to form a triploid primary endosperm nucleus. That means between two male gametes, one male gametes fuses the nucleus of egg and it produces zygote, and the other male gametes fuses the two polar nuclei and form triploid endosperm nucleus. Since the process involves the fusion of three haploid nuclei, it is known as triple fusion. Three haploid nuclei means two polar nuclei and one male gametes. It results the formation of endosperm. And then name the nuclei involved in the triple sperm. One male gametes nucleus and two polar nuclei are involved in this process. The what is false fruit? Give an example. What is false fruit? We know fruits are developed from ovary. Fruits derived from the ovary and other accessories, floral parts are called false fruits. On the contrary, true fruits are those fruits which develops from the ovary but do not consist of thalamus or any floral part. That means the fruits which developed only from the ovary is known as true fruits. But the fruits which are derived from the ovary along with the other accessories like floral parts or any other parts is known as false fruit. Apple is an example of false fruit. In apple, the fleshy receptacle forms the main edible part, hence it is a false fruit. What is apomixis and what is it the importance? Apomixis is the mechanism of seed production without involving the process of meiosis and syngamy. That means when without meiosis and syngamy, any other seed produced, this process is known as apomixis. It plays an important role in hybrid seed production. That means for production of hybrid seed, it plays a very important role. The method of producing hybrid seed, it is difficult and expensive for farmers by sowing. It is difficult to maintain hybrid characters segregated during meiosis. Apomixis prevents the loss of specific characters in the hybrid. Also, it is a cost-effective method for producing seed. As hybrid fruit production is expensive and very difficult to a farmer to produce, apomixis helps to produce seed without involving the process of meiosis and syngamy.